Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 25th video class of DIP, we will study periodic noise, noise estimation, and band pass, band reject filters and its implementation in MATLAB. So as usual, starting with the name, what is the meaning of periodic? Periodic means something that repeats itself at regular intervals. So a periodic noise will be one that will be repeating at regular intervals. Noise estimation means to find out what type of noise it is, and once we find out which type of noise it is, we can apply the band pass filter or band reject filter to remove that particular noise. So as the name suggests, the band pass filter will be passing certain specific bands of frequencies and rejecting other bands. Conversely, band reject filters will be rejecting certain band of frequencies and passing other bands, and hence will be able to remove the noise. In the previous video class, we have studied different noise types such as Gaussian noise, Rayleigh noise, Erlang noise, gamma noise, exponential noise, etc. But those noises were random noises, were not periodic noises. And therefore, in this video class, we are considering periodic noise separately and its removal techniques in detail. And we will implement the periodic noise and the removal of periodic noise in MATLAB. So let us start. Starting with the slide that we saw in the previous video class, we saw that there is a degraded image which is degraded by periodic noise. As you can see here, the continuous patterns that are repeating on the image. And when we take the discrete Fourier transform of this degraded image, the periodic noise looks like these dots in the circular fashion in the frequency domain. So we know that these are the noise that we want to remove or we want to reject, and hence we can use a band reject filter that will be just rejecting this particular circular band and hence rejecting these dots and hence rejecting the noise or the periodic noise, and our restored image after filtering will be like this. So the periodic noise can be reduced by setting frequency components corresponding to noise to zero. So we can see here that from visual inspection we can find out where is the periodic noise, and hence we can apply different techniques to remove it. Let's go ahead and understand in detail what is periodic noise and how to estimate noise. What is periodic noise? Periodic noise is sinusoidal at multiples of specific frequencies that repeats itself. Periodic noise in an image arises typically from electrical or electromechanical interference during image acquisition or image capturing process. An image affected by periodic noise will look like a repeating pattern that has been added on the top of the original image. This periodic noise can be significantly reduced via frequency domain filtering, and the periodic noise is the only spatially dependent noise that will be considered in this chapter. Let us understand estimation of noise parameters. The parameters of periodic noise typically are estimated by inspection of the Fourier spectrum of the image. As we saw in the previous slide, the periodic noise tends to produce frequency spikes that often can be detected even by visual analysis. See, the automated analysis of periodic noise is also possible, but in situations in which the noise spikes are either exceptionally pronounced or when the knowledge is available about the general location of the frequency component of interference. The parameters of noise PDFs may be known partially from sensor specifications also, but for this it is often necessary to estimate them for a particular imaging arrangement. Also, sensor noise can be estimated from the small patches of reasonably constant background intensity that are visible over the image. So in this way we can estimate different noise parameters. Let us go ahead and understand periodic noise reduction by frequency domain filtering. The periodic noise can be analyzed and filtered quite effectively using frequency domain techniques. The basic idea is that the periodic noise appears as a concentrated burst of energy in the Fourier transform, and our approach will be to use a selective filter to isolate the noise. So there can be three types of selective filters, that is band reject filter, band pass filters and notch filters, that we will understand here. First one is the band reject filters. As the name suggests, the band reject filters are used to eliminate frequency components in some particular bands. The transfer function of ideal band reject filter, Butterworth band reject filter and Gaussian band reject filters are given here. And these are similar to the frequency domain high pass and low pass filters that we have already studied in the previous classes. As you can see here from the figure of ideal band reject filter, it will be rejecting this particular band and will not be passing this band and passing all the other frequencies. It is given by the transfer function h of uv is equal to 1 if d of uv is less than d0 minus w by 2 and if d of uv is greater than d0 plus w by 2. So it will be 1 for these two cases, and if it is in between D0 minus W by 2 and D0 plus W by 2, it will be 0. That means it will be rejecting it like this. So you have to remember the equations. Similarly, the Butterworth band reject filter can be given by this equation, where W is the width of rejection. Here also W is the width of rejection, and N is the order of filter. As you know, Butterworth filter will be having some particular order. That order will be given by small n, and if it is order 1, it will be only 2 or square. And similarly, the Gaussian band reject filter will be given by this equation. So you know here that D is the Euclidean distance that we find out. D0 is our cutoff frequency, W is the width of rejection, and small n is the order of the filter. So we will use the Gaussian band reject filter and remove noise from one image in the MATLAB. As the high pass and low pass filters are complement or opposite of each other, similarly the band pass filters performs the opposite operation of a band reject filter, or the complement operation of band reject filter, and it can be obtained from the band reject filter itself. So the transfer function of band pass filter is given by 1 minus transfer function of the band reject filters that we just saw in the previous slide. The next filter is a notch filter. A notch filter is a filter that attenuates signals with a very narrow band of frequencies. A notch reject filter is used to eliminate frequency components in the predefined neighborhood about a center frequency. A notch filter rejects or passes frequencies in predefined neighborhoods about a center frequency. So it is a special form of a band pass or band reject filter. So instead of removing the entire range of frequencies, it only removes selective frequency components. And it is useful in removing a periodic signal of a well-defined and known frequency, like the interference patterns caused by electrical disturbances. So this is the transfer function for ideal notch reject filter. This one is the transfer function for Butterworth notch reject filter, and this one is the transfer function for Gaussian notch reject filter. So for ideal notch reject filter, it will be rejecting the components if D1 is less than or equal to D0, that is cutoff frequency, or D2 is less than or equal to D0, and passing all the other frequencies, where D1 is given by this equation and D2 is given by this equation. So you can see in the plot that it is rejecting this particular band and this particular band. Similarly, the Butterworth notch reject filter is given by this equation, where N is the order of the Butterworth filter, and the Gaussian notch reject filter is given by this equation. Similar to the previous cases, the notch pass filter is just the opposite or complement of the notch reject filter and is given by this equation. So here only the selective frequencies of D1 of UV and D2 of UVs are rejected. So you can see from this equation that the notch reject filter becomes a high pass filter if U0 is equal to 0, V0 is equal to 0. So if you keep U0 and V0 as 0, the equation will be under root of U minus N by 2 whole square plus of V minus N by 2 whole square, and D1 and D2 will become equal, which is equal to D, and D is nothing but the Euclidean distance, right? So the H will be equal to 0 if D is less than or equal to D0, and 1 otherwise, which is nothing but the equation of high pass filter, right? Similarly, the notch pass filter will become a low pass filter if U0 is equal to 0 and V0 is equal to 0. I hope it is clear. Let us implement band reject filter for removing periodic noise in MATLAB. This is the MATLAB program for Gaussian band reject filter, and this program is similar to the Gaussian high pass filter and the Gaussian low pass filter programs that we have developed in the previous video classes. So you can refer to those video classes first for better understanding. As usual, we are reading an image. The image which we are using here is a cameraman image. Then I am adding some noise to this cameraman image using this for loop, in which I am taking the original image and adding the noise using sinusoidal function sine of phi I plus of sine of phi j, and the resulting image A_1 will be my noisy image, which I'll be subplotting in one of the portions and naming image with noise. Then as usual, I'll be plotting the Fourier transform of the image. I'm shifting the origin, and I'll be displaying frequency domain image in the third portion, and then I'm choosing a cutoff frequency of 52, which can also be called the standard deviation sigma for the Gaussian, and I'm taking the width of rejection as 10. Then again running the for loops for different rows and columns and finding out the Euclidean distance using d is equal to under root of u minus m by 2 whole square plus of v minus n by 2 whole square, and the filter mask which I am finding out h of uv is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus of 1 by 2 into d square minus d0 square upon d into w whole square. So this mask is the filter mask for Gaussian band reject filter, which is multiplied with the noisy image, right? Then as usual, I am plotting Gaussian band reject filter in the fourth portion. I am plotting the surface plot of the Gaussian band reject filter in the fifth portion, and I am plotting my Gaussian band reject filtered image in the final sixth portion of the plot. So let us run and see the output. So you can see this cameraman image, which is degraded by a lot of periodic noise, and this is the Fourier transform without the shift. This is the frequency domain image, that is Fourier transform after shifting, and you can see that in this particular circular portion the noise frequency components are present, which I need to remove using the Gaussian band reject filter. So this will be my Gaussian band reject filter, which will filter out this circular noise components. The surface plot of this Gaussian band reject filter will be like this, as we have just seen in the previous slides, and the output Gaussian band reject filtered image that I will be obtaining will be like this. And you can compare this output image with the noisy image, and you can see that the majority of the noise or the periodic noise has been removed. Let us run the same program with another image, which is 512 cross 512 image. The cameraman image is a 256 cross 256 image. So I'll enable this, and as this image is a color image, I'll be converting to grayscale image. I'll be disabling the cameraman image, and now the cutoff frequency and the width I'll be changing because my image size is different, right? So I'll be using 102 cutoff frequency, and width I'll be using 12, and I will again run the program. So you can see this original image is corrupted with a very high periodic noise, which after filtering has become a very clear image. The MATLAB code for this video class is given in the description box, and also the MATLAB code of all the previous video classes are given in the respective description boxes. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a very good knowledge from this video class. Thank you very much.